this is kind of a warning to a lot of people who, you know, will be interested in buying even a sound system or, you know, just anything for a good price. Or even if you go anywhere, there's scammers out there who will trick you into buying a piece of shit for, it'll really seem like it's a good deal. Let's see, go up. Now, this is Paramax. Cheap-ass stuff made in, like, Australia and shipped over here. A couple days ago, I was at Best Buy. It was my birthday a couple days ago. Still had some money. Went out to my car, and I had a couple friends with me, too, and was approached by a couple people in a newer town and country, a gold town and country van with not all the rims there, well, the wheel covers, and these couple people came out, and they're offering me a good deal on this system, a Paramax home theater system, G509, and, you know, here's the box right here. Everything looks all professional and looks like a great system. Oh, it's got 2,000 watts and it does all this shit. And they're showing me all this stuff and I'm thinking, okay, that's a good deal. And it's got all these little stickers and all this bullshit. Let's see, what else? Oh, and she's like, oh, and look at this. Goes for like $3,000. And they have this really convincing story that they've got, they're overstocked on it, and they have to get rid of it, and so they're asking, like, $600, and I'm thinking, okay, that's a good deal, but I've only got $300 with me, and so I get them down to $300. Didn't realize I was bargaining for a piece of shit that isn't even worth $20. Well, maybe $20, but that's it. But I don't know, I hooked it up, it actually sounds good. There's the same company makes, they change their names around, and some of the names are better than the others. I think Paramax, it's basically a high quality, shitty ripoff. Says it comes with, you know, 3-year warranty, and the amplifier, all this shit. Look at this. Okay, they're in, let's see, yeah, they're in California. Huntington Beach, they give you an address. I looked it up. It doesn't even look, it's like an apartment building. There's no warehouse or any of that shit. And there's no phone number, there's no contact. There is a fax number, which I think it's a fake fax number because it doesn't work. Neither does the email, and I don't know, everything looks legit. It's very convincing. And they've got, oh, they say they've got all this other stuff. They have these scam artists who trick you. It's very hard to resist. The manual's like freaking 13 pages. And most of it's just specs. There's no instructions. It sounds, mine actually, I hooked it up. Surround sound, it actually sounds very good. If you turn up the bass and treble, mostly turn up the treble all the way, it sounds very good. I don't think it has 2,000 watts. I think it's probably got about 300, which still isn't too bad. But, you know, if someone approaches you, and, you know, this really seemed to be too good to be true, and I've never been scammed before, so I wouldn't know. You know, I mean, you might think, oh, it's such a good deal, I don't think it's a scam, but it is definitely a scam. It's just not, it's not right. If, you know, anybody approaches you in a parking lot offering you this stuff, you know, just walk away. If you're going to buy anything, buy it from an authorized dealer. This was in a Best Buy parking lot in Ann Arbor, and that's where it happened, where it took place. And just beware, they're walking around doing all that. People also said, you know, if they do approach you, say, oh, you know, make an excuse to go to your car, close the window and call the cops, because they need to be taken care of. I'm not sure if there's any evidence or anything that they can use to arrest them, but there should be. But this is just a warning to everybody. Just ignore these people. And this is in Michigan, and they're everywhere, though. I've heard reports of it, you know, in Pennsylvania and Texas and a Lowe's parking lot. Just everywhere. They're all over the country. I'm still pretty pissed about it, but, you know, I'll get over it. But, yeah, even look this up. There's the model number. Just look it up. Look at some, there's other YouTube videos about it. Look at, you know, there's sites about, you know, rip-offs that are taking place. It's just all over the place. There's been, you know, thousands of reports. So, I'd advise you to look at that. And don't fall for any of their shit, because I got fucked. And not in a good way. I'm glad it was only $300. If I had $600 at the time, I figured that's still such a good deal, I probably would have given it to them. Even though I'm probably buying them booze money. But that's just a warning. Hope none of this ever happens to you guys, because it really is a bummer. But just keep an eye out for it. Even, you know, they seemed very friendly. Everything just seemed so real, but it's all bullshit. It actually doesn't seem bad quality either. Here's one of the speakers. But even if you look right here, the screws, they're not even real screws. It's just part of the plastic. You can't even tell. These knobs, you can see there's a little spot there where they broke it off of, you know, a sheet of plastic, so you know it made cheap. But even on the subwoofer over here, it actually seems very good material. If you take the cover off, I don't know if you guys can see it, but there's even a spot right in here where it looks like it's been glued together, which it probably has been. Can't even get the damn cover back on. Piece of shit. It does sound really good though if you turn up the treble and bass all the way, but I'd still, even if you do get one, I wouldn't leave it on all the time unless you're in the room, because I'm afraid it's gonna short out or catch fire or blow up or kill me or something. But just keep an eye out for it and just report it to the cops. But just a friendly warning, just so you guys don't get screwed like I did. So take care, guys. See you later.
A little up the road from the habitations of the towns we know. A place we saw the lights turn low, the jigsaw jazz in the get fresh flow. Pulling out jobs and jamboree handouts, two turntables and a microphone. Bottles and cans, or just clap your hands, or just clap your hands.